Hello and welcome to Juris Ed Academy. Today I'll discuss how you should prepare Constitution for UGC NET exam. So let's check that what type of question you should expect for upcoming exam. So apart from directly asked questions, you may see either application-based questions could be asked, or there will be mixing of three or four concepts, thereby forming a new question. So overall, your legal aptitude will be examined. Hang on for a moment and let us see that what are the important topics under Constitution. So here is a list given before you. These topics are extremely important and unskippable, not only for the UGC but also for other competitive exams. So prepare these topics and revise it as much as you can. Therefore, once you are done with your important topic, you have reached to the basic level of your preparation. Now let us see that what are the other aspects which you should add on to your preparation. First is the schedules. There are 12 schedules given in the Constitution. So try to memorize the amendments together with the year. Also, there are some functional items which has been given under the certain schedules, like Schedule 11, Schedule 12 and Schedule 7. So you should know that what is the quantum of those items and what type of items has been given over there. Second, borrowings. Like what borrowings has been taken from the other constitution. Also try to remember the important and recent amendments together with the year. So for this point, you just need to do a simple revision and brush up your memory. Third, know the constitutional bodies and national commissions given in the constitution. Try to remember their article number, the eligibility criteria, and the duration of their term which the member and the chairperson serve. Now, the next and the most obvious point which every law candidate must be ready with, knowing the landmark judgments. Also together with this, try to make the list of important judgments which has been passed from year 2017 till present. Next important thing that comes after this is knowing the important doctrines which has been covered throughout your constitution. Next, know the bills, that what kind of bills has been present in your constitution, and which House of Parliament is eligible to pass that kind of bill. What is the term of that bill which could be present in that House of Parliament? So all these things, aspects regarding bill, you should make a note of it or just try to memorize it. Now the last but not the least point, and this is the point which most of the candidates do ignore. Try to at least just have a bare act reading of Part 19. That covers the miscellaneous part of your constitution. Also for this time, know the provisions related to the cooperatives. So these are some minor points which can change your entire preparation level, because small things can bring big change. Now, finally, there are two things which can work as a topping to your preparation. One of them is solving previous year paper. This thing is definitely going to benefit you in two ways. First is repeated questions is being asked, so that will help you in this case. Secondly, it will help your brain to eliminate the irrelevant options also. Now the next thing which you should take care of is try to read and revise the index of Bayer Act, especially when the examination time is near. So I hope these two points are clear to you. So there is one common mistake which most of these students do commit before taking exam. Is they try to refer more and more books or more and more websites. So just try to eliminate this step, because this step is definitely going to create chaos and it will confuse you, and ultimately you will end up with stress. So just limit to few resources and to reliable resources, right? So that will boost your confidence, because you are going to have the repetition, you are going to revise it again and again. So that will benefit you. Please like and share this video and subscribe to Juris Ed Academy and hit on the bell icon to get the regular updates.